Workshop. Why a workshop? Well, getting your hands on is the best way to demonstrate how people work, the Cloud Foundry workflow, and to help understand the architecture. This is not a training course. It's more of an appetizer, but it should give you enough Cloud.gov that you can use your sandbox account effectively to start kicking the tires. And I hope also enough Cloud.gov that you'll continue to have more questions as you dig into what it can do. And that you'll pursue it for your agency. And I've structured this as a set of user stories, as if we're doing behavior-driven development. I, as a project manager, developer, or CISO, want some hints on the logistics of this workshop so I can participate effectively. I suggest that if you're working on a small laptop screen that you have on one side, your PowerShell or iTerm window, you have if you're working at home, have YouTube Live in one corner, and then the web page with these lab notes, which are shown in the footer, so you can follow along and copy paste. This is how I had things set up when I was practicing these slides with, it's small on a laptop screen, but the notes down here and a terminal screen on the right. Some of you are using Amazon Workspaces because you didn't have systems available to you that could run the Cloud Foundry tool. I found is that use your local Internet Explorer or Firefox to follow along in YouTube and to read the notes. If you can download the Amazon Workspaces client, great, but if you need to use the web client through Firefox or Chrome, it does work. And this. For those of you using Workspaces, you should have gotten an invitation. This runs by really fast. If you click through on it, create a password, and authorize yourself. When you get in, if you have to use web access, do that. Make sure that the registration code matches what you were sent. And then once you enter your credentials, the workspace you have should already have a link, an icon at the bottom for PowerShell. Open that up, size it down to one half of the screen, and then slide the whole browser over so you have, again, the terminal on the right and your web browser is over on the left. Assuming you have that set up, let's cover account creation. How many people here already have Cloud.gov accounts? Okay, the majority. So I'm going to go through this, though, for those of you who don't, because it was a significant minority. This assumes you don't already have an account with the GSA, EPA, or the FDIC. If you already have an account, make sure you can go to dashboard.fr.cloud.gov. and that your login still works. If you're having a problem with your login, operators are standing by to help you. If you don't have an account, you start at account.fr.cloud.gov/signup. By the way, the FR stands for FedRAMP. Before we got FedRAMP, we were just account.cloud.gov. We needed to move everything. When you go there, you should have the screen to send yourself an invite, and then you get a confirmation the invitation has been sent. When you get the email, you can click on the accept your invite link, or copy and paste it as necessary, and then you can redeem your invitation. Create a password meeting the standard complexity requirements. And when your passwords match, you can go ahead and click on the button to create a Cloud.gov account. Verify your login by entering your email address and password again. And here's where we get to a little bit of a stumbling block. At this point, you'll be prompted to set up your password, your one-time password authenticator on your smartphone. And the way this works is you'll need that on your phones, since we don't yet have PIVCAC enabled. You can use on your phone Google Authenticator, Microsoft Authenticator or Authy, depending what's approved for your use or your preference. These slides show Google Authenticator. Search for it in the App Store and install it, open it. On the main screen of Authenticator, click on the plus button to add a new one. And then scan the barcode. And this is where you point your camera at that code that's displayed on your web browser. And your phone will buzz saying that it's gotten the scan correctly. It'll display a one-time password for up to 60 seconds, in this case, 467810. You enter that on the screen in the cloud.gov registration process, click register. Do it one more time to actually log in, and then you should be able to get to the dashboard. If you're from one of the five agencies that didn't have a sandbox set up prior, you may need to wait 5 to 10 minutes till that actually gets provisioned. Don't worry about it. You'll be able to catch up by the time we get to that later on. If you do have your account already available, you should now see your organizations within the dashboard, and you can poke around in there. For those of you who already have an account, the process should have looked something like this. If you're going to dashboard.fr.cloud.gov, you'll be prompted to agree to the terms of service. Select your identity provider, which would be cloud.gov unless you're GSA, EPA, or FDIC. Log in, get the token off your phone, and enter the token, and you should be in.